morning children, how are you all? Hope you are safe and staying at home. So don't trouble your parents, right? So always maintain a social distance, wash your hands frequently, and what we should do? Wear mask all the time when you are going out and when you are interacting or communicating or talking with anyone. So always the other person should wear a mask and you should wear a mask. See, even now, why after so many days also, why teacher is telling again and again, why teachers are telling? Because the cases are going on increasing. There is a prediction that, you know, the second wave of virus, you know, might come. So we don't know. Still we have to be very careful. I know all the activities are going on in the cities, so people started working, shops are open, everything is fine. No, everything is not fine. Still, you know, if you take worldwide, there are lakhs and lakhs of cases, right? So people are suffering, people are dying. So don't underestimate. Always taking precautions is necessary. So as we learned SMS, so we have to maintain social distance, wear a mask and wash your hands with soap. Maintain at least a 6 feet distance should be there. Okay? And if you are, anyone is not wearing, you have to, don't hesitate. Don't feel shy. You have to tell them, please wear mask. It is good for you and good for other people also. Okay? So, let's start today's session. As in the last session, we discussed about the story of a tree. Yes, we discussed question and answers, new words and their meanings. Hope you are clear with the lesson. So today's homework won't be with the lesson meanings or something different, I thought. So today's homework will be, you'll be writing different kinds of animals depend on trees for food. Other than beetles, which animals or insects or birds, whatever, you will write a list of animals depend on trees for food. Okay, so this is your today's homework. And let's start today's topic, understanding words. So understanding words, today in that we have two topics, prefixes. What are prefixes? Prefix, this is very important children, it has a, everything has a meaning. So let's say prefixes are the letters or a group of letters. If it is more than one, two, three, so we will say a group. A group of letters added to the beginning of the words. So we are adding this group of letters to the beginning of the words. Some prefixes when added to words form new words. Right children? So, they form a new words that are opposite in meaning. The meaning of the word will change off and you will get a opposite of opposite of that word. So, since I am adding a new group of letters, it changes the meaning and give you an opposite of that word. So, let's do it this. Possible. For example, it is possible that you can study well, you can do well, you can do good in academics. It is always possible. But when it is, if I want the opposite, what I will do? I will add a group of letters. Now, the meaning of this possible changes. See, when we are talking with others, I think it's possible that, you know, this happens, you know, that happens, you know, so we always discuss it. And the other person will say, you know, try to, if they don't accept our statement, that is impossible, we cannot do that. So, the meaning of the possible changes and opposite will be formed if I add prefixes. If I add prefixes, the meaning of it will, word will change and the opposite will come. Possible means it happens, it can happen. But it impossible means it won't happen. Or happen, we cannot do it. It is not possible. Impossible is not possible. Right? It brought a opposite to the that word. So, for example, in the story, beetles find their new home in the bark of a tree to be quite comfortable. So, they are living in the bark of the tree. That home, new home for the beetles is quite comfortable. They are comfortable. They are happy there. So, let's see. But this causes discomfort to the tree. Now, it that prefix brought opposite to the comfort. Comfortable. Comfort. They are comfort or comfortable if I say. See, they are quite comfortable, but it causes discomfort to the tree. The woodpecker helps his friend to save him from this uncomfortable situation. So, here the beetles are comfortable with the new home. They are comfortable, they are happy. But if I add prefix, if I add prefix un, uncomfortable, who is uncomfortable here? Tree is uncomfortable, it is not happy. The beetles, you know, trying to stay in the bark, eating the bark of the tree. It is not comfortable. It's not happy. Because if the beetles will do that, soon the tree will die. Yes, children? So, comfortable means beetles are comfortable staying there. But the tree is uncomfortable. This prefix brought the opposite to the comfortable. To the meaning of that comfortable. So, we have more examples also. Prefixes such as un, in, this, miss, im are often used to form opposites. So, let's do a bit here. Using the above mentioned prefixes, form opposite to the words in the brackets to complete the sentences. So, first one, the task looked dash when we first began to work. So, the task look, it seems as they started the work, but the task, what a task means, work, whatever the work looked dash when first began to work. So, they thought it is possible. The task looked possible. It will work when they started this task. Whatever the task they are started to work, they thought it will complete. It is possible. But now it seems it is impossible. The task looked impossible when we first began to work. So, the answer would be impossible. Possible opposite is impossible. The second one, the story sounded dash, but Kritika said that was how it exactly happened. So, whatever the Kritika said, the story, whoever hearing that story thought it, they believed it. But the story sounded. The story sounded unbelievable. Now, the opposite of belief is unbelievable. The story sounded unbelievable, but Kritika said this is how it is exactly happened. Kritika said story, whoever listening learned, but they felt it is unbelievable. Third one, he dashed Paresh's words and ended up going to the theater room instead of auditorium. So, what is the opposite word of understood? Misunderstood. What is it? Misunderstood. See, children, I am trying to explain a topic. I will ask you, children, did you understand? Then obviously, you will say, yes, teacher, I understood. you will say you understood, and you might give a wrong answers later. That means, no children, no my dear, you misunderstood what I said. Then I will say. So you said understood, the opposite will be misunderstood. Okay? So no dear, you misunderstood what I said. This is what you should do. That is the explanation. The fourth one, the internet has been dashed. So connected, opposite is disconnected. If the internet is disconnected, we cannot access to our browser, our YouTube channels or classes, anything we cannot access because net should be always connected. If it is disconnected, then you cannot have access to any of the applications or apps, whatever you are using in the phone. Okay, next one, fifth one, Ritesh seems to be behaving rather dash with Satish these days. So fairly opposite is unfairly. On to the seven. It is dash hot for a winter day. Winter day usually we feel cold, but what is usually opposite? Unusually. Unusually. Move on to the now. We will move on to 41 page. Still we have two more bits. I could not find Rahel in the crowd. I thought she had become dash. Visible means you can see. Opposite is invisible. So eighth one is invisible. Ninth one, the story of the fire seems to have been dash in the newspaper. So represented means the presentation, the giving the story of that incident has been, what is the opposite? Misrepresented. Hope you are clear with this topic, children. Don't worry about writing the notes, I will send, don't worry. Okay, I want you to understand the topic. Okay, so what we have learned, prefixes means it gives the, when we are adding a new group of letters to the words, before that word it gives the opposite of that word. So these are the prefixes. So let's do the next topic. Look at these words. Rewrite, redo, re. So something we are learning, the prefix re. Prefix means whatever the letters we are putting in front, at the beginning of the word. There is one more topic will be there, suffixes. Suffixes means after the word. Okay, that is a quite different topic, children. These are called prefixes we add before that word. So it gives you an opposite of that word. So let's say, for example, okay, look children, whatever I am writing on the board, please write in your notebook. So sometimes it happens if you won't write properly, or if I have to say, like, you know, you have to write again, then I will say rewrite. Children, I know you wrote this, whatever I told you to write, but rewrite again. You do that action again. Rewrite. So I will use the word rewrite. So here, look at this. Here the prefix re, when added to the word, suggests a repetition of the action that the word shows. So first I told you to write. Write whatever I am writing on the board. Then I might say, you need a little more practice. So then I will say, children, again you rewrite whatever it is written on the board. You write it. You do that action, writing action, one more time. You write one more time. Okay? Now you got it? That is, when we say rewrite, we mean write something again. So when we say redo, we mean do something again. You perform the action again. Okay? So let's start with the baby. Hope you understood. With the prefix re. So baby, complete these sentences using the words from the box. So in the box, five words were given. So we'll try use those words to fill in the blanks. Okay, the first one is, we had to dash our old strategy. We have to replan. Replan. We planned something to implement it, but it didn't work out. We have to replan. Again, we have to do the planning. We have to perform that action again. Okay? Second one. Tarun went to dash his bottle. Refill. In a bottle, water is there. He drank that water. Now the bottle is empty. Now he went to refill. Fill that bottle. Refill. Again, doing that, filling the bottle. Okay, it's called a refill. Third one. Dash the device to complete the updates. See, children, whenever you are working with the computer, the Windows automatically updates its operating system. Now in fourth class, if anyone have computer at home, you observe that the Windows will be automatically updated with the new features, new files, so that you will learn those new features. Keep them updated, because if the Windows is not updated, whatever the applications won't work. Whatever you are working with, the Word, Paint, it doesn't work. So after updating, you have to restart the system. You have to shut down and on it again. That is called restart. Okay, we'll go to the fourth one. Sanya decided to rejoin the dramatic club. So she want to rejoin the dramatic club. Fifth one. They could not dash his name, however hard they tried. Recall. What is the fun? Recall. See, children, sometimes it happens is, you know, if I forget the name of the student, I try to recall in my brain by seeing that student. Sometimes it doesn't get it. So that's what it is called. I am not able to get in my brain that name. I know it, I probably forgot it, I am trying, but I am still not getting it. I am trying to recall in my brain. So recall is, they could not recall his name, however hard they tried. So hope you understood. These are the answers, and hope you are comfortable with re prefix. So this is the end of the session, children. So you hope you understood this homework, right? Different kinds of animals depend on trees for food. Okay, whatever the list, you can break it as much as you want. However the list, you can write different kinds of animals. That is your homework. Hope you enjoyed this session. In the next session, with the new topics, we will come and we'll learn new things. You have a good day. Thank you.